Hi guys, it's me, Jimmy, a geek. Finding a new motherboard for the new i7 processor, i7-5820K, i7-5830K, and then i7-5860X. Finding a motherboard for X99 chipset is really freaking expensive. You see, $293, $344, $498, $274. All these are really freaking expensive. So I found the most cheapest motherboard for the best value. It's called ASRock X99 Extreme 3 LGA 2011 V3 socket. Remember, LGA 2011 V3 is not compatible with the older LGA 2011. Remember that thing. So let's talk about this ASRock X99 Extreme 3 motherboard. To be honest with you, nothing special in look, design is quite boring. Who the hell care about design? Who really care about the features? Let's look at, they are saying that it's stable and reliable. Yes, indeed, yes, I have used a lot of ASRock motherboard for my AMD processors. Indeed, it's a quite good feature. You can see, indeed, yes, quite good. So let me now just look at the specs, the real specs. Enough with the marketing campaign of ASRock. Okay, brand name ASRock, model X99 Extreme 3. Remember, just go to new area, type X99 Extreme 3. Okay, this is for the new i7 X99 chipset. Remember, if there is written X79 chipset, you cannot use a new i7 processor, the 6 core one or the 8 core one. It have 4 memory slots, okay, the high end have 8 memory slots, so it means you can put the maximum 64 GB into it. It's for DDR4 overclock, this frequency, even it's for the lower 1060. To be honest with you, we couldn't find anything lower than 2133 MHz. We really couldn't find 186 or anything lower for this one for DDR4. It's for pure channel, okay, quite impressive. It's have 2 PCI. And then one PCI Express 16 slot, yeah, there are few slots, 10x SATA, yeah, SATA connection are enough, one Ultra M2, we really need, to be honest with you, two M2 socket for it, for the storage device, nothing special in audio quality, 7.1 channel, okay, about 1 giga bit card, okay, all the normal connection, and then let's see the USB. 2 USB 3 and 4 USB 2 hood. This is the weak point of this motherboard. This motherboard really at least needs 6 USB 3 and 4 USB 2. That is okay, but everything is now USB 3. We really plug a lot of USB 3. Basically, the X99 chip chest is for the content creator. You really need to plug your flash card, your camera, your webcam, your keyboard, your mouse. Only 2 USB. Yeah, this is one of the downside. Remember, if you really need more USB, you should look at upper high-end model, readily spent to $300-$400. Yeah, nothing special. So for concluding this motherboard, about this, to be honest with you, Blender rent review, this motherboard is extremely perfect. You are just buying the next gen X99 i7 processor, chipset processor, just for gaming or basic, or you are on a budget. Indeed, yes. On the other hand, I will say it's better you must go with the around $300 motherboard. I will show you. Let's compare with that. I think where's my favorite one for the best price? Yeah, MSI. Indeed, yeah, this one. MSI X99S. If you can spend around how much? You can spend around $80. If you can really afford this motherboard, if you're really not on a budget, you must definitely go with the MSI. To be honest, you ASRock build motherboard solid as a brick, but MSI, I'm a big fan of MSI, really, I don't know why. Their component last 4 years, they use the military specs components. This is a true gaming motherboard. If you're a real gamer, you already spend a little extra, and then you care about your design, you really care about your motherboard, should look sexy, indeed, you must buy this one. Let's see all the bell and whistle. Yeah, it's a quite good marketing campaign. It's an OC engine. Basically, it has a smaller chipset built in for the BIOS. Yeah, it have Sound Blaster, Cinema, let's see. Yeah, this motherboard is quite better than compared to the ASRock. Yes, I was talking about it use a military specs. It have a military class 4 components in it. It have the high capacitor, all this dark choke. Quite good marketing campaign. Yeah, indeed, yes. I'm really impressed with the marketing campaign. Now let's see the raw specs. Enough with the marketing bullshit. Okay, X99 confirm. You see, it have 8 slot compared to 4 slot of ASRock. If you're ready to spend extra $80 for the MSI, you will get 8 slot instead of 4. So it means you can max out the RAM at 128 GB, and then you can see at here 64 GB. So it means MSI will be a future proof. Same nothing similar. It have 4 PCIe 3x16 slot compared to only 2 PCIe x16 3 slot. It have 10 nothing special. 1 M2. To be honest with you, we need at least 2. It's okay, no problem. It have 8 channel audio. It's have a much better audio compared with the 7.1 channel audio. It have 8 USB 3. Now this thing you should really remember, for just $80 extra you will get extra 4 slot, you will get better sound with 8 extra USB compared to the 4 USB 3.0. And then you can see, to be honest, the dual panel and then onboard it have extra 4 USB and then 4 USB 2, and then it's a lot of bells and whistle compared to this one. Yeah, to be honest with you, I'm really impressed with that. So my final conclusion is just, if you're really on budget, you need the most cheapest best X79, the budget X79, best of the budget X99 chips and motherboard for the new i7, you must definitely look at ASRock X99 Extreme 3. Or if you are really on budget but you have extra money to spend, or you can skim some money from the graphic card or from the PSU power supply, it's okay. Sometimes you can really skim. To be honest with you, if you use a $40 US power supply, at the end of it's work. I never have any problem. Even I use the Antec power supply, Cooler Master. Even I use a cheap Chinese power supply. Never ever my computer fry. Yeah, it's better. You should really use a good quality power supply. Even you use a lower quality power supply, nothing will happen. You must definitely buy MSI X99 S Gaming 7 motherboard. If you are really looking for the best out of best value of money, to be honest with you must really buy this model. It's really awesome. So from that's all for today. So subscribe to my channel. Bye bye.